Welcome back, surf fans, to the Vance World Cup. We're live from Sunset Beach. Timmy Rays, Granger Larson, Kaito Kino, and Evan Valier. Yeah. What's your take on the conditions here right now?
I agree. You know, that swell is filling in as it's meant to. So it is on its way as we see Kaito Kino here. Tall kid from the South Shore, but has been pretty much raised here on the North Shore. Surfed here a lot as well. So he's comfortable in these waters. And here we go, live action. Looks like Evan Valier.
Evan Valier will be on his backhand, deep bottom turn, straight up under the lip, and he will go down. I like the approach from Evan Valier, known as obviously a great surfer at Pipeline, but he's had some solid results here at Sunset as well. And watching the ocean right now, we've already seen the waves jump up 2, 3, 4 feet, probably in the last hour, watching those three first heats with Dave and Pete.
Try to, you know, look at your quiver boards. What am I going to ride? I'm going to ride a 6.6. Make that a 6.9. You know, I'm going to ride a 7.3 for my heat. You know,
bring all your boards today.
It's just going to build all day. But with the wind alone and just catching waves at Sunset, that is half the battle. So you need that extra foam just to get yourself into the wave.
Well, with 20 minutes and 51 seconds to go, starting us off, Kaito Kino got a 4.67, which is a pretty decent score on the day. We said complicated lineup here today at Sunset as Kino up, in, and out real quick.
Yeah, I was looking Pancho, Sunny, Leo Neves. I was the guy looking sharp over here. I tried to do my best. I want to choose a waves. I can do a good turns, and that's it. I got a one wave with one turn in the wave. I got the points I need to make advance.
You know, they've all said it is definitely a blow, but that's what makes champions, is just the ability to rise up and make it back. Here we go, Kaito Kino. Foamy, menacing looking wall as he drives down the line. Comes through to this inside section, goes up to the lip. Challenging top turn. Probably, I would say, Sunset on the inside section has to be one of the sketchiest places in the world to try a turn.
To hit the
lip. So much water coming and wind, and just, it seems like the whole ocean is coming at you and working against you as you try to fit in a maneuver and turn on a big wave.
Hitting the lip at Sunset is no joke. You're going to get a lot of feedback from that lip. Once you hit it, it's going to push you back. So just the fact that Kaito kind of tagged it right there and then was able to land it, that's the hard part at Sunset Beach. You're going to land no matter what in the flats. It's going to feel like you're jumping from 8 feet down to cement. So it's tough to plant those.
Well, with 14 minutes, 50 seconds to go, this is our first look at Granger Larson. And he gets caught behind. You know, very, very complicated takeoff zone right now. You've got about 300 yards of ocean to work with here.
So, again, when that swell fills in, it'll get more predictable.
Now, Timmy Ray's having a look. Nice little late drop. Comes around this section. He's got a clean open face to work with. Beautiful carve back into the white water. Now he gets to the inside section. Jams a layback under the lip. Great approach from Timmy Ray's, of course. Today, through the rest of this competition, Sunset has a way of eating one's quiver. 8 minutes, 10 seconds to go. Timmy Rays, he's jumped right back into this. He's got a 5.6, 7, and a 3.3 to take the lead. Kaito Kino in second place with a 4.6, 7, and a 2.83. Ross, this was Timmy Rays during the recap.
Oh, there you go. Powerful carve there for Timmy Rays. And now he's just going to ride this into the channel. And, that's a pretty solid score for him. 5.6, 7, and then a 3.3. A little backup. Evan Valier on his backhand. Nice little snap there for Evan. So, you know, I think one of the tricks today, or the keys to success for getting those scores, kind of those breakthrough scores where there are fives or higher, is finding a wave, Chris, that has a wall on it. You know, something that can actually let you hit the lip or throw spray out the back. Anything that's going to look different from your normal kind of cutback that we're going to see a lot of today.
On most days, of course, you know of a pipeline gun, but for these guys, wow, up late, Evan Valier. Get to the surfboard conversation here in a minute as Valier, with an under the lip late drop, somehow maintains control and gets one turn on the face of that wave. And right behind him, very late lay down takeoff. Kaito Kino pulling in, makes it through. Nice snap on the open face. So Kaito Kino again backing it up multiple turns after a really scary looking tube ride. But maintaining control from beginning to end of that wave, that's going to be a nice score for Kaito Kino as we see the ocean starting to roar.
You can see activation officially underway here. That swell by the minute is getting bigger. That was amazing. I'm impressed with Timmy Reyes. I like the way he surfs Sunset Beach. But Kaito Kino, he's kind of owning this lineup right now. He really is sniffing out great waves. We saw him irk out like a little 4.67 when the waves are smaller. And now that the sets poured in, he's right in the sweet spot again. So really utilizing that local knowledge there. That was a classic prone takeoff there. That could have been 1983 in the Duke Classic. Kaito Kino getting a great barrel. That's going to be a big score. Nice little snap, too. The judges will realize it's Sunset Beach. It's so tough to put yourself in the right spot at the right time. And so for Kaito to get, even though he didn't get a super long, deep barrel, just the fact that he positioned himself in the pit here in a classic inside bolt wave at Sunset Beach, he's going to get rewarded heavily.
Very impressed with the reaction time that he had right there. Basically getting blown off his board on the takeoff, slammed onto his stomach, somehow the presence of mind to just jump up and find a barrel all within the span of about 1.5 seconds.
It's so easy to get slapped down on your stomach and stay there. It's really tough that once you kind of get down to the bottom and stand up, you're chopping all over the place. You're just trying to find your feet on the deck. He made it look pretty easy.
So with 4 minutes and 45 seconds to go, this is during the replay, a late takeoff for Granger Larson.
Granger just way on the inside here. You can see now he's eyeballing the wave. You can see him scanning back and forth. He's looking for something to work with. And so at this point, he's almost on the verge of heading into vowels. So he kicks out. So Granger, surprising, he's a little bit lost at sea.
Yeah, convoluting lineup here at Sunset. So board-wise, Ross, are there boards specifically shaped for Sunset Beach? It seems like the wave that could absolutely dictate that.
It's a great question, because if you have the luxury of being based here in Hawaii and maybe you live here, you have a surfboard shed where you have 30 boards, something like that. 7.83 right there, beautiful. Again, all the navigating, all the work he did before he actually got that tube ride was so impressive. It really does weigh into the judge's mind how impressive someone can pick apart a lineup.
Well, Timmy Reyes now live action coming through to this inside section. Tons of speed, but the wave just bouncing him around and not really giving him opportunity for any open face turn. So with 2 minutes 20 seconds to go, these heats going by so fast. And Ross, getting pounded out here at Sunset Beach, this is a wave that
the fellas, the blokes, these burly men that surf Sunset Beach, it's just got great history, as we see Evan Valier.
So Evan Valier, the sole goofy footer in this heat. Nice backside carve, another good snap right in the pocket. You kind of notice a lot of surfers will just widen their stance a little bit to handle Sunset Beach, and it's smart. Just gives you that a little bit more of a power base that kind of Sunset Beach at this size. We've seen it at a fun size the past couple weeks. There's days where you drive by and you just look out there and you go, that is a Hawaiian postcard. It looks so nice out there. Yeah. On a day like this, absolutely not user-friendly. But the competition goes on. Big waves and big scores in that last heat. Kaito Kino with a 7.83 and a 4.67, unofficially winning. Timmy Reyes in second.